Guys, and welcome back to my channel for another Search Die IRAE episode. And as you can guys can see, we're back here in the Cordon, and it's raining. Hooray! Isn't that beautiful? Isn't that fantastic? So we need to see if we can save people here. I think it's Fang. Or is it Ghost? I don't know. I just know that some people got captured by the Johnnies. We need to save them. Also, those dogs needed to die, so you know. I made everyone's favor. I made a favor to everyone. I made life easier for everyone. Easy game. It's weird that every now and then I have these freaking very weird time skips. Yeah, I really don't understand. Oh well, everything is working fine, so hopefully I don't need to go waste more money on stuff, on repairs and replacements. I think I spent too much of that already this year. Yeah, words just ran away from me. Well, they normally do. When you're not a native speaker, every now and then you'll forget about those words. But yeah, this past S.T.A.L.K.E.R. soup episode talked about how I had to buy a new office chair because mine just decided to, you know what, I've had enough of you and I'm committing suicide or whatever, or stop working. Well, that's the best, those are better words actually. I am going to cease to function. And it did, and I was like, wow, thanks, I needed that. And now, great. It's another freaking expense. That's exactly what I needed. Yeah, sure, buddy, whatever. I don't think I don't need to talk to any of these people. Do-da-da-do-da-da-da. For you two. Freaking bandits. Is he here? No. Just regular bandits. I wonder where their boss is. Or they don't have one. But yeah, expenses. Well, I know we're in December and Christmas and stuff, but I've been having a lot of pre-Christmas presents this year. And I kinda don't like that, as that messes with my savings money. And yeah, I don't have a lot of money left on my savings. Yeah. Oh, it's Captain Nemtse. German, hey. Hello, Yellow, Slaven, alive. The doctor said you could show up here, but I thought the whole man with these zombies was crazy. Well, that's great, bro. What did you join the army in the second round? What else was I supposed to do? Doctor and Pinochet are a great team. Doc is ancient and will soon move to the zombies forever. And Pinochet, well, Pinochet is a freak. He already lives with the zombies, doesn't give a damn. He doesn't care about anything. So I signed the contract. Soon it will be over and then fuck everything. Yep, so you're back. Luke Ashton brought your PDA from Pripyat. He said he took it from your body in the garage. What? And you saw that body? I've seen it. The doctor and I buried you. The guys couldn't get you out of kindergarten. You must be lying there. And you've identified me. Well, I had to be honest, was almost gone. The bullet was a 12.7mm caliber from a BSSK. We saw your tattoo, Ukrainian Naval Infantry Corps, initials of SC, sniper company in the year 1991. So you weren't buried at all? Where were you? I don't know myself. The last I remember was the power plant. Well, you're a big hoot. German, I'm looking for Ghost and Ramazov. Ramazov is near the fence. NATO shot him. It wasn't until then that my fathers had found him. I am now waiting for an investigation and a tribunal. And Ghost left. And I don't know where to find him. Ghost is probably somewhere in Africa. Okay. Yeah, something like that was in Razumov's PDA. Tell Gene the hacker to take a look. There are a few notes, but so clever scientific language that you don't understand shit. But 90% are encrypted anyway. So where's Daddy Yarolavskin? Vadim? Let's just say somewhere in the zone. I will talk to him about you. If he decides he needs you, he will find you. Listen. Learn all about the day of August 19, 2012. I think, though it was a long time ago, but he remembers. Okay, do your duty, Captain. Okay. Come and see us, bro. Come and see us, bro. So there's a dead guy here by the fence, huh? I need to investigate. Yeah, they're having fun listening to Marilyn Manson over there. Cool, huh? Holy shit, there's a lot of dead people here. Oh my god. Some Johnny Joes. All dead. And Colonel Remezov. Well, that sucks. That sucks. So, where do I need to go? Eh? I have no idea. Is it the bandits that were calling me? Say, come talk to us, bro. Father Kovtsur. Okay, well, we'll see. We'll see what Father Kovtsur wants. What was this? But I saw something there on the radar. Well, it's nice to have friendlies here, finally. This guy's friendly. Let's see over here. Real quick. Just regulars, I guess. Just regulars. Let's go see the stupid bandits. I think it was them that talked to us. Thought I heard something over there. Yeah, you know, stuff. The zone is not a safe place after all. Guy looked like he was taking a nap or something. Whoa. There was a man inside here. There wasn't a man inside here. Father Kovtsur. Well, hello, I guess. What's up, Father? Look what we have here. Slavin, here. You're now like a colorful dog. At the latest since the Agroprom incident. The brothers are happy, and the thing with King and the anger in garbage. You slowly become a made man in the zone, Slavin. What did you want from me, Father? I look at you, brother. You are a strange child of the zone. Feared and respected and always already with one leg in the grave. German, the captain at the roadblock, ordered you to be shot. I'm gonna wrap your guts around the neck. Oh, come on, that's bullshit. Oh yes, I swear to God. Okay, gangster, I'll deal with German. Look, I drove away, I'll come back for you. Yeah, German is yeah, these bandits are lying to us. Because the fourth chapter we're going to play as Jervin. That's why it's a lie. Oh boy. I really hate these go back and forth. It's a little bit tiring to run without a vehicle. Hey, I need a conversation with you, German. Very delicate. Tell me, I'm listening. Kovzer said you ordered me dead. Have you lost your mind in the power station, or has someone shit in your brain and forgotten to stir it? I wish I could punch you in the face, but I'm in duty. You bastard, Slaven, if you believe the bandit Kovzer. I wouldn't talk if I would believe it. I would take care on you from the hill, that's all. I should have taken that bastard off the books a long time ago. What does he want? And so we tolerate them here on Cordon, but now patience begins to burst. Come on. Let's go get a couple of shoppers to punish them. Do you have any contact with the flyers? With who? You're a penguin in the middle of nowhere. The helicopters are drones now. Autonomous onboard computer with AI program. When a steel bird hangs over your head, you stand there and guess, human or AI? And get shot. GPS system, motherfucker. Yes, I guess something like that. Okay, let's take into account. I'll finish the conversation with Father Kovzer. Rotten Bazaar. I knew it. I knew that German was a nice guy. We dealt with him on the first chapter. Yeah, the bandits are all riled up. That means that they want to get us. They're out to get us. Yep, just as I know it. When I heard them all upset and stuff, I knew that things were going to go south very, very, very quickly. Ah, the bullet drop on this gun. But when it hits, it hits. And then they fall down and they're dead. There we go. Is any of these bastards dead? Yeah, there's one. Oh, I see you there, you little asshole. It's like that grenade went into the proper place. Just blew up on his face. It's pretty funny, I love it. Anyone else? That was worth it. That was absolutely worth it. Oh man, that grenade never gets old. It was beautiful. I love it. I freaking love it. Okay, that's Wolf. I would be surprised if it was these assholes that actually killed Wolf. And then they said, no, Wolf blew himself up, sure. I'm starting to think otherwise. I think it was these assholes that killed him. I think they just, you know, surrounded him and, you know, flanked them and whatever. These guys blew themselves up. Beautiful. I hope it was worth it, you dumbass. I don't want your gun. Your gun sucks. Yeah, I don't like bandits, so That was a bonus for me, not having to work with him. I knew he was lying. Because, like I said, we dealt with Germany in the first chapter of this series. Now, here on the second chapter. And now, in the first chapter is about him. Hey, hey! Anything else, German? Tell me, but hurry up, I'm angry today. The roof's moving. I'm angry too, Slaven. I should finish with a gang of Batke Kotsu. We'll be able to do it quickly. Well, will you help the army? That's exactly what I wanted to do. A call from German. Okay. I already have. Ah? What? Is there more? German don't want any problems with the rest of Father Kopser. It is necessary to clear the cordon. Okay. I see, so we need to find the rest of them. And wipe them out. Okay, well, fair enough. Let's do that. Let's do just that. Well, to be honest, he didn't give me any chance, these assholes, to talk to them. They just started blasting. Well, they were lying, come on. We could see that from a freaking mile away. I bet that there's more over here somewhere. We'll need to deal with them. But yeah. Expenses. I hope you guys all have already got your Christmas presents. Because I already have all the Christmas presents that I needed. So it's better to get them early in the month than wait for the last minute, if you know what I mean. Last minute shopping is it's annoying as hell. Nice shot, bro. You almost had me. There we go. These guys are all dead. I don't know if there's any more of them left. We'll need to check. I still need to go and get the God damn it. There's that part over there that I'm pretty sure there's bandits there. They're probably all friends of them. Would not be surprised. Well, Father Kovtsur, which is now deaded too. This is the gang of the idiots. Yeah, now I need to buy Christmas presents. Yeah, I'm just rambling right now. Yeah, I don't care about you. Get out of here. I'm busy rambling. Although my rambles are not very coherent right now. Not very coherent. Yeah, I'm not going crazy. I'm just, how do you call it, too focused on what I'm doing to actually give proper speech. But yeah, this year was a year with a lot of expenses, believe me. Was my car being annoying when the wiper motor failed? That was the wiper motor arc, where I couldn't find the wiper motor to repair it, so my mechanic actually had to buy it from eBay, which sucks, if you know what I mean. But luckily it works, and it works fine, so that was one less to worry about. Then my GPU decided to fail. Like, oh great. And then, speaking of which, I don't think my GPU was failing at all. And I might have sold it at a low price to someone that now has a perfectly working GPU. Yeah. I think all you needed to do was a factory reset and it would work normally. And I did not do that. I didn't do that. Fantastic, huh? So I think I might have wasted a lot of money. Well, and then there was my share, which I had to buy another one. All the cool stuff, I guess. All the cool stuff. There's no one here. I think this is the last place where the bandits might be. If there isn't any bandits here, I think we're cleared. I think we are golden. Yes. But yeah, I think this year sucked. It was terrible. Terrible for my savings. I actually considered exchanging car this year. But I was like, ugh. No. Assholes. More assholes. I decided not to. Because I have a perfectly working car. I don't need another one. Does that make any sense? Yeah, well, with the exception of the wiper motor, which, you know, it's the part, you know, planned obsolescence or whatever, that nothing lasts forever, that was destined to fail. It was making some weird wiper motor noises anyway, and I thought they were perfectly normal. I thought, well, this, you know, I didn't know that the wiper motor on this car made this nice noise, so probably normal. And that was actually the sign that it was dying. Yeah, I thought that I was hearing someone play the guitar, that's why I stopped. No, just Marilyn Manson playing in the distance. And then I thought it was the, you know, the alternator that wasn't charging the battery properly, which, in case, no, the alternator is fine and the battery is also fine. All of that is fine. The problem was always the freaking wiper motor, after all. Yeah, now that I have that sorted, I don't need to worry about rain anymore. I even bought a water repellent. Okay, well, I think something happened that wasn't supposed to happen. Let's quick load real quick. I think I killed all of them, unless I have to. I clear the cordon. There's no more bandits in the cordon. Hey, hey! See you later. Am I missing something? Am I missing something? I don't think I have. I went here, there was nothing here. Clear the cordon. I think I've cleared the cordon, unless I'm missing something. Well, I'm going to... I'm going to end this session here. I hope you guys have enjoyed this episode. Thanks for watching. Stay safe and stay well. And I'll see you guys next time.